In this video, I'm going to introduce you to META GPT, which is a multi-agent framework, and you can access it at mgx.dev. In a way, this is similar to something like level.dev, bolt.new, or v0 in the fact that it is a web-based coding platform. But it's different in some ways that it has multiple agents doing different things. And I'll get to that as soon as we get started. So we will go to mgx.dev. And if you look at the interface, it is very similar to the other tools that we have used. We have a very simple chat interface, and you can just paste in the prompt and start coding. Okay, so we have these models, DeepSeek chat, there is GPT-40 mini, Claude 3.5 Sonnet V2, and we have Claude 3.7 Sonnet as well. I'm just going to select Claude 3.7 Sonnet. And if you want, you can click on this add button. You can upload files, upload folders, etc. You have all these buttons that you can click. You can click on this button and then create a link tree like website if you want very quickly. But I'm just going to give this prompt. And this application is something that I had to build to solve a particular problem that I had. And I have actually built this earlier. I'm just trying to rebuild this using mgx.dev. So what this application does is basically, if you create a voiceover in 11 Labs or any software that you have, which is a voice generation software, the AI generated voice has a bit of a problem. It doesn't know what is the actual pause length, right? So basically some words which should have a pause ends up being together. There is not enough pause between two words. And I didn't want to do it manually by going into each sections and increasing the gap. I wanted an automated solution. And in the end, I'll show you this exact application, which looks like a proper audio editing interface, which was built using a combination of V0 and cursor. I'm just saying, can you build me an application that will detect silences in an audio file? If I want to increase the pause or silence length, I can add a value to increase the silence throughout the audio file. Wherever there is a pause of a certain length, I can target each of those pauses in one go and increase the length of that pause. Now, as soon as I run this, you will see that this application is different compared to the rest that I mentioned earlier. So I'm just going to click run and let's see. Okay, so it opens up this interface just like every other program that we have tried out. But here, there is a difference. On the right side, you have all these agents which are doing different things. There is Mike, who is a team leader, who will do all the thinking and plan the entire project so that other agents can do whatever they need to do. So we have Mike, who is a team leader. Then we have Emma, who is a product manager. There is Bob, who is the architect. There is David, who is a data analyst. And Alex, who is the engineer. And for this project, I'm assuming we're going to work with Mike and Alex, who is the engineer. So right now, if you see on the left side, Mike, the team leader, please develop a web application that can detect silences in audio files and allow users to increase those silence duration. So he's giving the project to Alex, who is the engineer who has started coding right now. So far in my experience, this has given really good code and it has been good at creating applications a little more in detail, but it does run out of credits very, very quickly as well. Because we are working with multiple agents, that is another fact that I have noticed. And I have to see if we can get to a workable solution in the free tier itself for one day. And I've also noticed that in this case, if you run out of quota in a single chat, then you cannot restart the same chat the next day, which you can do in something like lovable.dev. Even V0, I think you can do that. But in this case, that's not possible. And if you see on the right side, you have the files here and you know which agents are working on these things. And this is an editor, you can edit it. And on the right side, you have the terminal. Then there is the planner where the details of the project is given. Then there is the editor, which is this one. And you have the files. Okay, all the files are here. I'm just going to close that. The good thing about this is that once the coding is completed, it will give you a link. You can click on the link and open the app and see it functioning. And if you want to share it with others, you can do that. So Alex, the engineer, has been coding for more than 12 minutes now, and it's still going on. So let's see when the output is ready, I'll get back to you. Okay, so we have finished it. Okay, I'm just going to go to App Viewer And let's copy this one. And I'm going to paste that link here. Okay, I'm going to upload an audio. I will upload this audio file. And then the processing is going on for audio visualization. We should get a waveform here, I think. And yes, I'm guessing it will take a little bit of time to bring the, yes, that comes in. I can play the audio. Yes, I can. Play and pause, stop it. Okay, so we have the silence detection and modification. So the silence threshold is set to minus 45 dB and minimum silence length is 0.3. We have to first detect the silence. Okay, it crashed, I think. So obviously there is an error. So I'm just going to say fix this. The silence detection brings in a blank page. Okay, so I have fixed the issues that were causing the blank page problem in the audio silence modifier app. The main changes include so-and-so. I'm just going to... Okay, so it has just modified the design of the app itself. It looks slightly different than earlier. I'm going to open that page once again here. Okay, so that's refreshed. So I'm just gonna click here and import this audio. Okay, so it will do its thing. Let's not bother about that. It was fine earlier. So I'm just going to worry about this thing. Okay, I'm gonna say detect silence. I'm gonna keep it to minus 45 and the length to 0.3. Increase silences by 0.5 seconds. Okay, I'm gonna say apply silence modification. And then download modified audio comes in. Let's download and see that. So there is very little visual information right now, but let's see if it adds those pauses that we had asked it to do. Okay, so I'm going to download it. I'm going to go here. Okay, this is the file and the length of the audio is, you can see 5353. So it is 53 minutes and 53 seconds. And the original audio, I'm just going to go there and see here, and that is 4353. So basically it has added about 10 minutes extra because of the additional pauses that we added here. So let's actually listen to it and see if the pause has been added properly.
Close your eyes for a moment, if that feels right for you. Take a deep, slow breath in. And gently
there is a pause added, and I think there is some kind of artifact there. There's a like tick, some sound there. That's probably that pause that is added.
Moment. Right here.
But with additional music or something like that, I guess this whole problem can be solved. Like I said, I had already created this application before using other tools. First, I created using Lovable. It had a bit of an issue which I didn't like, so I went into V0 and created it. And it gave me something that I liked. I took that and went into Cursor. And whether it was from Lovable or V0, the output or the app interface looked more or less like what you can see here. But then I took it to Cursor and then I turned that into this. So this is the application that I have right now. So let's say I'm going to import this one. And the audio will be imported into the app itself. And once it's done, I can click on pause extension and have all these options and I can click on apply and it will add those pauses. And once those pauses are added, the similar artifact that we got from mgx.dev, that the tick sound is there right now. So for that, I've added this cleanup glitches button and I click on that. And that glitches will go away as well. And that button will only show up after pause extension is added. And other than that, in this application, I added other features like equalizer, you have compressor, you have normalize option, and you have limiters as well. Soft and hard limiters can be applied as well. I also wanted an option to slow down the audio, or let's say to reduce the tempo. I really was not able to do that without changing the pitch. So I just let go of that idea and I just kept the app like this. But this whole design and all of these things, apart from the main functionality, was really created in Cursor. So if you want to create any particular application, you can create it using multiple applications. And I think this is more or less similar to a Lovable and V0. I think V0 and Lovable is a lot more easier to use. Lovable is probably the best of the lot so far. So I just wanted to showcase this application to you guys. And to be frank, it is good, but for specific scenarios, if you have projects that you need more planning, I think these additional agents will be of help. But other than that, I think it's an okay product. I still think that of all these tools, Lovable is the better option. Even Tempo Labs allows you to create those PRDs and stuff like that. But most importantly, the free plan is very limited. So you don't get more than 3 messages in the free plan, which is a bummer. So that's it for this video. If you'd like to watch more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, and share it with your friends. And I'll see you in the next one.